place last season. First time they've been outside the top six since the days of George Graham. Gabriel leading into Sochek.
There's a reason me and Dylan like to watch the fish.
It's because they are our
wish. And they're not on the dish.
And they give us real bliss. That's why me and Dylan
love our fish. I want to film it so you can watch the fish too. Because you'll enjoy them because I cleaned the tank today. And you'll see
what a difference it makes. So as me and
Dylan, we love our fish. But they're not on the dish. They bring us real bliss. We love our fish. They are our wish. Is that right, Dylan? He's gone to sleep. Look. Hello, boy. You gone to sleep? Oh, look at you.
Boy. You're beautiful. I love Dylan. Show them the fish.
we should just stop. Just stop for a couple of years.
Other than my dad going in and out of prison, family life was fantastic. You know, our mother gave us everything. I mean, we lived in Rainbow Mansions with chandeliers, fantastic, beautiful carpet. She would do the house out, and then we'd have beans on toast for dinner. You can't really like.
Anyway, nobody really liked me for some reason or other, and we were not allowed to play with him, and he wasn't allowed to play with him.
Nobody that I know didn't go out of Leeds not ending up being chased by the old Bill. You know, he did. You know. I mean, my poor cousin came down from Wales, he was probably only about 16, to work for the band for some time on, you know. And he said he went in a clothes shop with Lee, and Lee said, just hold this bag. Before he knew it, it was stuffed full of all sorts. And then he went to run. This old man was a crook, you know, and Lee, you know, took up the mantle. I mean, in some ways it's kind of sad because, you know, I know from talking to Lee that he was often made to do things, you know, his dad would push him over the walls and go, you know, you're not getting back until you come back to something stolen, you know.
He was quite a nice kid, but I wished he wasn't there most of the time when he was little, because he wasn't a good influence on my
enormous efforts to bring up my children to be decent, upright, middle-class English children.
He was supposed to call me one night and he didn't, so I ended up going to the youth club with my mates. And then I saw him in the back of the Black Mariah going up, can you stay out right? Look at him.
He turns up at school and the streetwise teacher realises that, the saxophone's obviously stolen or bought, or it's a dodgy saxophone. He's got the serial number scrubbed out.
Is it nice?
Yes,
yeah,
nice.
Before social media and all that, you know, you literally, if you had an album you liked, you'd carry it about under your arm, you know, just to let people know what you were into. Because there was no other way of expressing who you were, apart from your clothes.
At a certain point, we got Woody and Bedders, and they were like, you know, almost like professional session men.
But my first initiation with him was that we were rehearsing over in Finchley Road, and he had the yellow GPO van. He drove the yellow one, Mike drove the white one. And yet he said, oh, I'll give you a lift back, back in Hampstead, and you get a train back home from rehearsals. And he took me on a death-defying, frightening ride at some, I don't know what speed it was, because I was actually almost in tears of sort of fright. And I think that was my kind of, that was pleased to meet you. You know, I think he wanted to see, to kind of get a reaction out of me.
Both Lee and Mike had ex-GPO Morris Minor vans, you know, that's how we do our work, you know. We did gardening jobs together as well, and you could put all the gear in the back. And then at night, if we were doing a gig, you'd have to take all the crap out and put the amps and all that. And the worst bit was when we were doing the gardening, it was staying perpetual, so it was, you got the driver, you got the passenger, that was like, you get to spin a coin, everyone else in the back, and you just come out stinking perpetual, which wasn't the most alluring thing where girls are concerned.
Lee, when I first met him, was a bit scary.
Well, you know,
when you're in there, waiting around, right? And
you
have to play it wrong. But why do you play the piano? Why don't you stick your piano? Why don't you want me dressed on there? You know what I mean?
I would stick my piano if you could play the thing properly.
He's always pulling the reed off the end of his sax to get the right tune.
And Lee would just sort of flit in and out. He would appear maybe at a rehearsal occasion, play a bit, and then he would disappear.
Mike was absolutely determined that they were going to be a pop group, and I said, well, does Lee have to be out? Because he kept on not turning up from rehearsals, and Mike would be moaning when I was in the kitchen, and I said, well, why don't you kick him out? And he said, no, this is very important, he's got the right English.
I was, you know, well into my reggae. And Tracy, what is this thing? In the dark, all in the cycle. It was a bit wrong. And he's like, what does it mean though? What's it mean? I'm like, I'll tell you how much you want to be at the other.
Yeah, I remember telling Mark about reggae, I didn't forget earlier when we first started and being a little bit, you know, dubious about whether, you know, whether you, I mean, those days there's a question about whether a white man can play reggae. An agreed that white men couldn't play.
You can see that the fish are our wish. They are not on a dish. They are our bliss. We love our fish. I hope you enjoyed watching them.
Happy Saturday night, everybody.
And enjoy whatever. And remember, the fish.
They're just real. And they shine on like you do and me. Shine on, everybody.
Cool, but sometimes they would like to be so to take it.